Good morning, students. Myself, Sandeep Gulati. First, I welcome you all on my first online video. Before we start this video, you can keep your 7th standard computer book with you. Dear students, today we are going to learn our first computer lesson, Computer Fundamentals. In this lesson, we are going to learn about first input devices, second output devices, third software and computer languages. But in this video we are going to know about only input devices. Dear students, open your book page number 1. So see there, after that I am taking one by one. See here, you know that students, computer is a combination of hardware and software. So hardware, so what is hardware? So hardware is a physical parts of the computer which we can see and we can touch. For example, keyboard and mouse. So keyboard we can see and we can touch. That's why keyboard is an example of hardware. So when you observe carefully, there are hardware devices. Again, there are main four types of hardware devices. In this lesson we only discuss about this input devices, but there are more than another types of also. So first is input devices, second is processing devices, third is output devices, and last is storage devices. But in this lessons we only discuss about this input devices. So for example, what is the input devices? So input devices only used for feed the information, feed the data into the computer. There are different types of input devices. For example, keyboard, mouse, joysticks, mouse, scanner, these are the examples of input devices. But in this lesson we learn about this advanced input devices, which advanced input devices. So I am read this chapter carefully one by one, paragraph one by one, and after that we can discuss it. See carefully, open your book page number 1 and see the paragraph number 1st. A computer consists of a number of interrelated components which we work together to convert the data into the information. The data is fed into the computer with the help of input devices. The computer process the data to produce meaningful result. These results are then represented to the users with the help of output devices. This, dear students, when you see this paragraph carefully, in this paragraph here some you can see some input devices, processing devices and output devices. Because computer work on IPO cycle. IPO cycle means input, process, output. So when you give any instruction to the computer, so we are using input devices. After that, when you send this information to computer process it. It is called processing. And after that, this information sent to the monitor and other devices, for example printer. So these are your output devices. It means that computer always work on IPO, input, process, output. Okay, next paragraph. In your earlier classes you have learned about some common input and output devices. This lesson discuss some advanced input devices like barcode reader, OCR reader and so on. It is also discuss some output devices like plotter, LCD projector. The lesson concludes with the discussion on the qualifications of softwares and computer languages. Dear students, see here. Here input and output devices. No, you know about that basic input and output devices. But here we know about the advanced input devices, for example barcode reader, OCR reader and so on. It means these input devices, simple means normally we are using keyboard, mouse, scanner and joystick, but nowadays we are using barcode reader, OCR reader and so on. See next paragraph, second page number next. See here, input devices. I am reading this. A computer can accept inputs both manually and automatically. In the case of manual data entry, the users has feed the data into the computer by hand using a keyboard, mouse and joysticks. In case of automatic data entry, the information is directly transferred from a source of documents into the computer with the help of special input devices such as barcode reader, OCR, OMR, MICR. Let us learn about some of things input devices in detail. See students, in input devices normally we know about that keyboard, mouse, joystick, scanner, these are the input devices, but in this lesson we are learn advanced input devices. For example, barcode reader, OCR, OMR, MICR. So we can discuss this in detail. See the next paragraph. Barcode reader. I am reading this paragraph one by one and I am explaining it one by one. You can listen carefully. So barcode reader or a barcode scanner is an input device which is used to read the barcode of a product. A barcode or a universal product code is a machine readable code in the form of light and dark lines of varying width which usually appears on the wide variety of the products and books. This code includes some information about items, price, code and its manufacturer details. For example, students, here when you purchase this, every product having one code. This code is called universal product code. For example, you can purchase your computer book. Okay, so when you turn this book, you can see one barcode is there here. So this, when you barcode is there in the, when you scan this barcode, so all the information about this book you can see on computer screen. Which type of information? See, first is what is the price of this book, 175 rupees. Next, what is the weight of this book, 271 gram. And what is the name of the book, the information technology. See, this all information you can see on the computer screen. This is the called, this is called, you see downside is a number is there and some black lines are there. This is called barcode reader, and this device we have to use to scan the barcode. This is device. So when we can scan it, so after that you see the, all the information about this book. It means that no need to type this information again and again. So next paragraph, see, a barcode reader generates light to reflect the image of the barcode. It then identifies the image from the thickness and spacing of the bars which the image is identified, and it is converted into the numeric code which can be proceeded according to the requirement. See student, when you see this barcode, this is the one kind of barcode. When you see, when you purchase anything, for example the product, any product, for example this is our computer book, you see your GK book is there, you when you purchase your notebooks and any other products, so you can see one barcode is there. So this, when you scan this barcode, so all the information about this book you can see your computer screen, numeric code. But here most important, when you see here downside, different numbers are there. Okay, but computer understand only machine language, and when you see this, there are in machine language there are only two digits, 0 and 1, but here you can see more than one numbers, 6 9 10 11, but computer understands 0 and 1. Here is very important, this information convert into convert into machine language. So that time we need compiler, interpreter, assembler to convert the program into machine language. There are different computer languages. In next then we can discuss it in details. Next paragraph is, barcode reader is widely used in supermarkets, departmental stores, libraries and other places. They can be either fixed positions or handheld. With the fixed positions readers, items having a barcode are passed in the front of the reader either by hand or a conveyor belt. The handheld readers are not fixed at one place and are brought in front of the item to read their barcodes. See there students, this is the barcode reader. See this machine, this device, you see here in blue color, this is the button. When you press, after that you listen one beep, and after that this machine scan the barcode. See the barcode, 1 2 3 4 5, and this is the barcode, and this device is scan it. So nowadays these departmental stores, supermarkets, libraries, they are using this technology. Why they are using this technology? Because they want to save the time, and this device very easy to use, very easily and very fast we can do the calculation. In departmental stores you see rush is very rush rehta hai wahan pe. So you can see there, so they are using this to billing, and after billing you see the all information about this, what is the weight of the product, name of the product and price of the product. You can see on the computer screen. The supermarkets and departmental stores and libraries, they are using this technology to minimize their time. Next is optical character recognition. This is one of the input devices. We can see when you carefully, this is the like a pen, but this is one input devices. Optical character recognition, this is the process of providing text as an input to a computer by means of a document reader. The first major use of the OCR was in processing petroleum credit card sale drafts. Over time, other application involved including cash registers, stock control, tap readers and market surveys. OCR is also used for recognizing handwriting. So this is next, this is the input devices. And what is the use of this device that time? So processing petroleum credit card sales draft. Another is this, including cash register, stock control, tap readers and market surveys. They are using this OCR technology too. Next paragraph in, the OCR system consists of optical scanner and a special software known as a OCR software. The optical scanner is used to produce a digital image of the text document. The OCR software then convert the including bitmap image of the characters into the computer understandable code. This code is then interpreted by the computer as letters, numbers and special characters. So this OCR, but when you scan it, so you see this like a pen. And we can, when you scan this line by line, so this line to line type on your computer screen. Okay, next is paragraph. OCR system makes the data entry fast and efficient. However, if the document is not typed properly or written clearly, it becomes difficult for the OCR system to recognize the characters. A disadvantage of the OCR system is the most of the text formatting is lost during the text scanning. See students, this OCR is the electronic or mechanical conversion of image of typed handwriting of or printed text into the machine encoded text. It is a popular technology that can be read a machine printed documents. For example, anybody want to type, so they are using keyboard. But when you typing, that time you need some time. But when you use this OCR, so it is when you move on the line, so it is automatically type on your computer screen. So this is the one of the input device. Next is our input device is optical mark recognition. See student, this is all are the advanced input devices. So third is optical mark recognition. The optical mark recognition is the technique of recognizing as pre-specified marks made by a pencil or a pen on a paper. The OMR technology enables to high speed reading of large quantities of data and transferring this data to the computer without using keyboard. Generally, this technology is used to read answer sheets of objective type test. In this technique, special forms documents are printed with the box, which can be marked with a dark pencil or ink. The specified marks on the paper should be positioned correctly and should be significantly dark than the surrounding paper. The forms are then passed under the OMR reader. The result obtained by the reader is sent to the computer. See this device here, figure number 1.3 OMR sheet. Listen student, 2 years back you are in fifth standard. That time you were given one scholarship exam, and that time you see OMR sheet. And next year you will be in 8th standard, and that time also one scholarship exam is there. And nowadays government taking different types of exams, and that time they use this technology OMR sheet. So why they are using this sheet? First, this device calculate at one times many answer sheets. But when teacher take this, check this answer sheet, that time they need more time. But this device in 1 second, many answer sheet, check. So that's why this technology nowadays we are using. And next is magnetic ink character recognition. This technology used in banks, especially bank, they are using. Okay, magnetic ink character recognition refers to the technique of recognizing special magnetic codes. These codes are printed using the special font, which consists of numerals 0 to 9 and some special characters. The special ink, which contains magnetized particles on the iron oxide, is used to print on the codes. MICR is widely used in bank. The magnetic codes are generally found at the bottom of the bank's check. These codes includes the bank's identification code, name and branch, account number and the check number, which are printed before the check is given to the customer for use. The check is then passed through the MICR reader, which reads all the magnetic codes on it and send the information to the computer. The bank industry prefers MICR because it provides additional security against forgeries. If a document has been forgotten, for example, if a counterfeit check is produced using a color photocopy machine, the magnetic ink line, which will either not respond to magnetic field or will produce an incorrect code when scanned. See students, I am showing one check of bank. See the picture and we can clear this. When you see this check, this is the State Bank of check. Here it's IFSC codes and downside you can see the check number. How many digits are? There are 6 digits and MICR code is 9 digits. And account ID with RBI and transaction code. So this is the MICR code. So MICR magnetic ink character recognition line is used to mainly by the banking industry. And MICR code is a 9 digit code. So MICR code is a 9 digits. So first 3 digits represent the city code. The first 3 digits represent the city code. Next 3 digits represent the bank code. And last 3 digits represent the bank branch code. Sorry. And MICR code is located on the bottom of the check leaf next to the check number. For example, this is the check number and here is MICR code number. So this is 9 digits. First digit, 3 digits show the city code. Next 3 digits show the bank code. And last 3 digits branch code show. So this is the MICR code. And this MICR code printed on your passbook also. All information you can see on passbook. So I want to show this this check. Why? To clear your doubt. So how MICR? This bank industry use this technology. Why they are using this MICR code? If you MICR code is very important. Okay, see this picture carefully. Figure number 1.4, MICR reader. This is the one kind of input devices. Next device is magnetic strip. So this is technology used in especially in ATM card, debit card, credit card, like this. A magnetic strip is a special type of strip which is used to store data. It can be stored up to 60 characters. The data on the magnetic strip is stored magnetically and the data once stored cannot be changed. The magnetic strip is generally used with this plastic card. The strip is placed at the back of the card. In the most of cards, the magnetic strip is contained in a plastic like film. A special device called magnetic card reader, it is used to access the information stored on the magnetic strip. The plastic card is swept through a magnetic card reader to read the data on the strip. A magnetic strip is commonly used in the credit cards, identity cards and debit cards. See students, nowadays we are using this ATM cards. ATM card means debit card and credit card, and with the help of these cards we can purchase everything. For example, you are going to departmental stores, any others, so you can pay the bills. So this is one kind of magnetic strip. So when you observe carefully this picture, figure number 1.2, magnetic strip, you see this black line is, it is called magnetic strip. So when you are going ATM and then you put your ATM into ATM machine, after that you see one in all information, when you fill up all information, here is no need to type your account number, nothing, just you have to type your PIN number and amount. So when you press this, all the information automatically read it, and after you fill all information, after that you get all the cash. Okay, you can get cash. Okay, so this ATM card, debit card, credit card, and now when you are going petrol pumps, they are also use this card to pay the bill. So you can check, observe your surrounding area. There you can go and check it. So there are in a surrounding area, you can use this ATM card. No need to keep money in your pocket. So you can use ATM card, and very easy to use, very easy to use. And next is, our next point is smart card. A smart card is a pocket sized card which is contains the microchip. It is possible to write information on the chip as well as read from it. For example, a person using the smart card can get value added to his card from his and her bank instead of carrying cash. A special device called smart card reader. It is used to read the information from the smart cards. Today, smart cards are used as SIM cards for mobile phones, authorizations cards for pay, televisions, and public transport payments cards like the Delhi Metro line card. See this smart card. This is the smart card. And now in our Maharashtra also, they are using our Mahamandal. They also give this smart card. So when you are going one place to another place, so these smart cards are there is no need to purchase ticket. Every day we can purchase ticket and we can travel, but some are going again and again this place, so they are purchase this smart card and only pay the bill, only pay the money. No need to buy a tickets. So this card used for tickets. So just you have to show the, and after that you can travel. Next is touch screen. A touch screen is a special kind of input devices which enables you to choose an icon or a menu item displayed on the screen by simply touching it with your fingers. Touch screen use either optical grids or a pressure sensitive film. They register the input when you touch the screen with your fingers. A touch screen is normally used when information has to be accessed with minimum efforts. However, it is not suitable for the input of large amount of data. Typically, it is used in ATMs and information providing system like those as hospitals, airlines, railways reservation counter, and amusement parks. See these students, this is a touch screen. Nowadays we are using smart mobile phone technology, so you can see touch screen is there. So our finger is like input device, and when you are going ATM machine, you are using your fingers. So this is touch screen. Nowadays we are using laptops, touch screen laptops are there. Our most example, our smart mobile phone, our we can touch the, this is touch screen. So these all are the advanced input devices. I hope you can understand, and my humble request to read this lesson carefully. If you can't understand, so you can read again and again, and any problem is there, in next lesson we can discuss about this. So first you read this lesson carefully and find out some important words. For example, in this lesson, okay, in this lesson we learn about this first different barcode reader, this OCR, MICR, smart card, credit card, like this different input devices. But here input devices, okay, next lesson we can see the output devices. So thank you, stay home, stay safe, goodbye.